Let's talk a little bit about the matchups. Now, I was lucky enough to watch Airborne stream. 83rd minute, scored a tap-in from a rebound off the post, sent them through to the top 8, knocked PlayNation out. Honestly, that's everyone thought Generals were going to miss. I saw the poll. It was about 62-38% in favor of FFA. But in typical Generals fashion, they didn't repeat season 15. 14 wins, 5 draws, and 11 losses. Notable mentions, Damo with 17 assists and 4 goals in 23 games. Niazi with 20 goals and 6 assists in 23 games. And Skids with 69 interceptions and 52 tackles. Onto their opponent, Olympus Elite. A really poor season for them. Only 18 wins and 9 losses. 5th place, last season they had come 3rd. They missed out on the top 4 by only 3 points. If they had beaten Real Deal in the last match of the season, they would have climbed into 3rd. But yeah, we lost 4-0. Still, boasting a plus 45 goal difference. Notable mentions were Dark and Shadows with 19 assists and 10 goals, Zaty with 32 goals, and the two centre backs, Laterbra and Sesto. If I had to give a prediction for this game, yeah, there's no way I'm going to bet against my team, but it'll be a close game. Generals are just one of those bogey teams where if they show up on the day, they'll definitely beat a team. They can beat anyone, but I'm going 3-1 Olympus Elite. 6th versus 7th, Powered versus Hectic, whatever you want to call it. This is going to be an insane matchup. Razzlers, obviously, I caught it sort of earlier on in the season when they were coming first. I didn't think they'd have the, the momentum to keep going throughout the season, just like season 16. Started off super strong, new signings were coming onto play. However, they've ended really weak. But in saying that, still equal 5th, just with a lower goal difference. Only 5 points off of 3rd. And on their day, they can beat absolutely anyone. 17 wins, 6 draws, 7 losses. I have to give huge shoutouts to Hectic and his back line. 17 clean sheets in the whole season. Obviously a silver glove, silver brick wall. I think Deadly Sars really shined this season. 21 goals, 5 assists in 30 games. Ozilla, 15 goals, 10 assists. Tons with 64 interceptions, 50 tackles. Overall, a really mixed season. Plus 27 goal difference. I think the way they're going to dictate how they've gone this season is how they go in finals. So obviously they need to start by beating Sin City. But Sin City, mate. 7th place. Probably the biggest underdog story out of this whole season. 3 points above 9th, plus 3 goal difference. Lots of people were predicting them out of the top 8. However, under the guise of Le Pogba and Asher, they've been really good. Not only that, but for Poet and for PK Pro to get a bronze brick wall and a bronze glove, for Shamri to get 21 goals, for Brycey to get 15 assists, for Asher to get 84 interceptions. They come into the finals with probably some of the biggest confidence out of every team. For predictions, I really think this is going to be a close game. This is going extra time, in my opinion. 2-2, extra time. I'm saying Razzlers are going to nick it just at the end. Deadly Sar penalty, 3-2, 115th minute. Now, the top 4 of Season 18. With 22 wins, 5 draws, 3 losses, a plus 60 goal difference. Ilzuri started really slow. It looked like they wouldn't even make the top 4 at one stage. But they've been one of the best teams on the back end of this season. Their defense has just stepped it up. Mbeule, Dom, Kotze, Maddie, they've all gotten a gold glove now, gold brick wall, 18 clean sheets, and it's a testament to how they've been playing. Conceded the lowest goals out of anyone with only 13. They've scored 73. With Fletch not being as available, Veach has stepped up, 26 goals, 15 assists. Harry stepped up, 12 assists, 4 goals. Jules, 12 goals, 10 assists. Envy with 8 goals and 7 assists. But for me, most notably, it's been the DMs. Gillard, 82 interceptions with 44 tackles. For an Ilzuri team that's so attacking and barely relies on defense, to get those numbers. His counterpart, Brumo, 87 interceptions, 77 tackles. They've been hugely insane. I think they've only lost about 1 in the last 14 games. And now that it's finals time, can they back it up? I know they have the experience, you know, one of the most experienced sides when it comes to finals. Will they choke? Will they buckle? Or will they back it up? Will they go for the AVPL? It's all going to start, but it has to start against one of the most informed teams out of the whole season. You're talking about first season, Sin City coming onto the scene with a bang. Well, Real Deal have gone one better. They've come third place in front of the likes of Ozone, Olympus, a team that's been formed on the basis of mixing a whole bunch of players from other teams together, and it's just worked so well. Goldie and Kiri at the back have locked it up, Raiken's been scoring the goals, Lockie's been insane, Rashford's been excellent. Sammy Boy, two-time Team of the Season winner with 74 interceptions in only 22 games. New signing Snitch has hit the ground running. They are a big team killer. They've beat Razzlers, they've beat Hollywood, they've beat Olympus. Can they beat Elzuri? Now, I think they actually did. However, there was a whole positional issue. But bottom line is, they're one of the teams that had beaten them. They're just a very smart team. And if I had to predict, it's going to be nil all. 100% nil all. It's going to go into, I think, second game Elzuri will nick it, but it's going to be zero all for about 170 minutes. I'm going with the Jules top right finish inside the box. Last but not least, Hollywood versus Ozone. Let's start with Ozone. 18 wins, 6 draws, 6 losses. Now, they've come quite a far way considering Grimes predicted them to miss the top 8. They well and truly deserve top 4. I think Connor's been outstanding. 20 goals, 6 assists. Probably one of the signings of this season. Same thing goes with four-digit Fiasek. 24 goals, 7 assists. Stan has been outstanding. Brash with 70 interceptions and 44 tackles has been an absolute rock. And Homochuk, Nico, 110 interceptions, 57 tackles. He's been one of the best DMs this season. And Rick Tran, 20 assists, I think he's gotten the bronze dishmaster. He's orchestrated the attack really well, and Ozone as a whole, plus 43 goal difference, they're going to be going into this game wanting to win. And if there's a team that can upset Hollywood, it's probably them. But this is the last season premieres that we're talking about here, and not only that, they've backed it up again this season with 122 goal difference. That is by far the best goal difference I have ever seen. 150 goals scored. That's more than double of Elzuri in 73. The fact that Mark has 58 goals in 30 games with 32 assists and Naylor has 44 goals with 46 assists, that should tell you everything you need to know. Shout out to Jordy Brio 2, 26 goals as a winger, Nugsy, Fardy at centre back, Bo, Jordensky. And as a prediction, there's no betting against Hollywood for me anyway. I'm taking the safe option. I'm going to go 3-1 Hollywood. If your team's made it to the finals, good luck. Make sure not to delete the live streams because I want to watch them back. All the best, and let's hope Olympus Elite win.